Cast your mind into the future, and there could be something big coming over the horizon. Something that's arguably greater and more significant than any scientific discovery that preceded it. The uncovering of, or arrival of, true alien life. And while science fiction has long decorated our imaginations with what real aliens will look and be like, we're just not sure on exactly how first contact will play out. There are so many moving parts, potential pitfalls, and possible surprises. However, one thing that's seen by many as statistically likely is that alien life will be smarter than humankind. In an infinite universe, the chances are high that otherworldly beings will be much more advanced. So what would that mean for us? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if aliens were just 5 times smarter than us?
Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content.
Without a direct example to refer back to, how do you measure extraterrestrial intelligence? For the most part, we rely on theoretical frameworks, such as the Kardashev scale or John Barrow's model of microdimensional mastery, to inform us on what to expect. We can also incorporate theoretical products such as von Neumann machines, self-building, self-replicating, and self-proliferating AI bodies. And we can picture the wealth of knowledge that an alien group might have if it were to have harnessed, say, wormhole technology or universal consciousness. But really, there's no telling the specifics that an extraterrestrial life form would have at its disposal. And equally, for all the advancements that they might present, they could also be much more primitive than us, non-complex, and even single-celled. But again, there are predictions to suggest that if or when we do cross paths with aliens, it is much more likely that their intelligence, in whatever form, will far outstrip our own. So perhaps the place to start is with ourselves, by measuring the limits of humankind. Because what would it actually mean for a species to be 5 times smarter than us? While the reliability of intelligence quotient, or IQ, is much debated, it's also the most widely recognized measure of intelligence that we currently have. And although exact scores are difficult to pin down, an IQ of near or even more than 200 is considered extremely high. So it figures that an alien 5 times more than us would be 5 times more than the best of us, which means an extraterrestrial mind that's operating at a staggering IQ of 1,000. Already then, this isn't just superhuman intelligence. It's on a whole new plane of existence. Such advanced beings would process information at speeds beyond our comprehension. While the quickest human processes at upwards of 70 bits per second, a 5 times smarter being would be able to handle a mind-boggling 350 bits per second. In general, this means that their thought processes would be lightning fast, allowing them to solve complex problems in considerably less than the blink of an eye. In reality, it would make it impossible for a lowly human to understand or even recognize how that alien brain works. Some have even suggested that that last part is why we humans wouldn't even know if we had discovered alien life in the first place, because we simply wouldn't be able to comprehend it. So as we burrow deeper into this hypothetical scenario, let's next consider how this superintelligence would manifest. First and foremost, a 5 times humanity alien would boast scientific advancements light years ahead of our own. Judging by various predictions of our trajectory, this could mean that the very fabric of reality as we understand it would be an open book to them. An alien that's 5 times more intelligent may have mastery over traditional physics, biology, and chemistry, all of which would produce technology beyond our wildest dreams. We're talking total governance over physical matter, which means all elementary particles sifted and redistributed for ultimate efficiency. A complete understanding of organic life, including of consciousness, which means potentially total control over, say, a human brain, or over human emotions. But really, the overriding fear with something quite so smart is that it will inevitably deem human beings to be unnecessary, which means stripping and redistributing the particles that make us and assuming total supremacy over our conscious thoughts, if only to extinguish them forever. But let's imagine that things don't unravel quite so quickly as all that. Let's consider we're fortunate enough to encounter a much smarter alien and initially live to tell the tale. Even without an instant death knell, there could be trouble ahead. Communication with such beings would be challenging, to say the least. Imagine trying to have a conversation with someone who perceives time differently, or who understands the universe differently, with someone who has moved beyond language itself, or with a being that comprehends life from literally all new dimensions. It would be something like the challenge faced by a beetle if it ever wanted to start chatting with a human. It would be impossible. It's vaguely hoped that the language of mathematics may transcend all possible differences between two alien forces, but that's only really suggested from a human point of view. Could it be that a 5 times smarter alien operates with different math? Could it be that our math would turn out to be just another limiting factor? Ultimately, it has to be asked whether advanced enough aliens would even notice us. Consider how most humans go through their lives wholly unaware of the microbes that are all around them every single day. Wouldn't we represent something just as seemingly inconsequential to another higher power? On the other hand, perhaps the advanced empathy and understanding of a more intelligent species would actually lead them to treat us as precious beings in need of guidance. Or maybe that's just wishful thinking. Overall, the potential impact on humanity, if 5 times human aliens were discovered, could go one of two ways. On the one hand, simply exposure to this level of intelligence could catapult our own technological and scientific progress. Just knowing that such advancement was possible might translate into an unparalleled opportunity for us to learn, grow, evolve, and improve. In fact, this is one conclusion imagined by the so-called zoo hypothesis, which argues that aliens may be watching us from afar, as though we were animals in an enclosure, and that if those aliens were to ever remove the barriers between us and them, it would only be to welcome us into a higher level of galactic society, to encourage us to learn and embrace a new grade of knowledge. From there, perhaps all of our IQs would gradually soar towards the 1000 mark. Maybe all of us would develop abilities to process information at 5 times our current speed. However, on the other hand, there's the risk of overwhelming cultural and societal upheaval. Human civilization is built by us for us, and so the revelation of a higher intelligence could serve to very quickly wreck it beyond saving. All our current systems, politics, healthcare, money, education, even science itself, might crumble under the weight and scrutiny of our new hyper-intelligent alien onlookers. Our understanding of morality, ethics, and even of reality itself might be suddenly challenged. It would likely be all too much for the relatively puny human brain to handle. Again, we can draw some conclusions from the natural world. For example, imagine you're an ant. You're part of an established colony. You have a role in your ant society, and everything is seemingly good and stable, until such a day as a human being decides to dig up the ground in which you live, or cut down the tree, or flood out your home by simply upending a no longer needed bucket of water. With an intelligent enough alien, we're the ant, and they're the, perhaps unknowingly, rampaging human. Our chances of survival are slim to none. And so the conclusion is twofold as well. Because what if smarter than us aliens hold the key to unlocking the mysteries of the universe and they're willing to pass it on to us? It would be an encounter to dramatically reshape the future of humanity. But what if smart aliens don't want to share or even fail to notice that we're anything worth sharing with? It would be a development to stop humankind in its tracks once and for all. It's a prospect that's thrilling and daunting in equal measure. It could trigger an ascension into a new era of enlightenment, or a rapid downfall towards inevitable extinction. But that's what would happen if aliens were just 5 times smarter than humans.
We know humans are curious creatures. Whether we're studying ants, trying out recipes, or inventing space travel, our quest to know more knows no bounds. With aliens, though, would they share this trait? Would they also harbor curiosity? Research suggests yes. Adaptation, surely an essential skill for any intelligent organism, has been shown to link with curiosity. Therefore, it arguably makes sense to expect that any alien life that does manage to survive would also be interested in learning more about us, if they ever found us. It would most likely be within their nature. But how exactly would they do that? This is Unveiled, and today we're asking the extraordinary question, is this how aliens would spy on us in real life?
Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content.
If there is another civilization out there in space, do they know about us? Until now, we certainly don't know about them, and remain alone from our perspective as a species. As such, it's hard to imagine any scenario where humans wouldn't want to learn as much as possible about alien life, if we were ever to discover it. The chance to watch life not as we know it would simply be impossible to pass up. But that doesn't mean that we'd make contact immediately. Rather, we'd want to view from a distance, and preferably without our subjects knowing anything about us. We wouldn't want them to know that we know they're there. It wouldn't be the only way forward, but many see it as the most likely, which presumably makes it the most likely course of action if the tables were turned, too. An alien race watching us might also prefer to hide themselves, and for any number of reasons, including out of fear, out of concern that they might alter our evolutionary path, they might spread disease or kill us off, or simply out of an abundance of caution towards the unknown. Say an alien group has been watching us, then what do they know so far? One unfortunate aspect of humanity is clear, that we're a violent species. We're divided, and war and murder are frequent occurrences. If they've been watching since World War II, then they'll have seen the atom bombs over Japan. More broadly, they'll have seen how we treat animals, smaller organisms, and even other people on Earth for personal gain. Indeed, a reconnaissance mission to Earth might turn any potential alien away from ever physically visiting it, based on observation. And so, watching in secret could become crucial in order to keep tabs on our progress and assess the risk that we might pose to the rest of space. A von Neumann probe is probably the best way forward. A von Neumann probe is a hypothetical spacecraft that's outfitted with advanced AI capable of self-replicating and putting itself into position around exoplanets, moons, or just about anything else in the universe. Theorized by the physicist John von Neumann, the probe could potentially mine asteroids for the materials needed to build more versions of itself. But its wider value to interplanetary espionage is clear. If humans were to discover a sure sign of alien life, it's likely what we would send to investigate it. If it were possible for us to build just one of these probes, then we'd soon have multiple of them, as is their design, watching our cosmological neighbors. So again, we might expect an alien group to do the same thing when targeting us. The self-replication is ultimately the most original and vital capability of a von Neumann probe, as these things could fill a whole galaxy over time, perhaps within just a few million years. As they spread and spread, they give whoever launches the first probe an opportunity to gradually tighten their grip on whatever planet or civilization they wish to monitor, and because of the small size of each individual machine, to do so without being detected. Consider the prospect of von Neumann probes crossed with nanotechnology, and there's even more potential to spy and truly remain invisible. But according to some, with tech that's not even that advanced, and only slightly better than our own, an alien civilization might have already managed to put such a probe in place around our planet, should they have wanted to. The physicist James Benford is a leading voice here, suggesting that co-orbital objects, or objects that revolve around the Sun from the same distance as the Earth does, offer the ideal location or cover for alien spy technology. Probes either on, near, or masquerading as co-orbital objects are always close to Earth, while remaining a small enough speck against the backdrop of space to go unnoticed even by our best telescopes. In general, co-orbital objects haven't been studied in depth so far, because they were only discovered by us just a couple of decades ago. So when it comes to mapping the solar system, these things are a looming gray area. Other potential hosts for a von Neumann probe, or a fleet of von Neumann probes, include our moon and even the upper reaches of our own atmosphere. While no real evidence has ever been officially released of possible alien tech on the moon, theories abound, and some are more compelling than others. Meanwhile, the Black Knight satellite remains the best example of a theorized probe within our own atmosphere, and we took a closer look in another recent video. Most mainstream analysis agrees that it's probably just a discarded piece of space debris, But could it in fact be the beginning of a von Neumann surveillance network? Then again, there's some argument that a watching alien race wouldn't actually need to send probes of any kind at all. It may feel as though telescopes have been around forever, and therefore aren't especially cutting edge. But actually, even just on Earth or launched from Earth, they're improving at a staggering rate. The recently launched James Webb Telescope is 100 times more powerful than the Hubble Telescope, humanity's former flagship mission. Looking further ahead, however, there are already plans to develop telescopes that are large, powerful, and accurate enough to see the surface features of a target planet in detail, perhaps as clearly as we currently see our own world via satellite imagery. Estimates vary, but at the most optimistic, it's hoped that we might achieve this within the next 100 years. So, could a hypothesized alien race that's just a century more advanced than us already have this capability? And could they already be using it to watch our every move? Or might they have chosen a different path that we humans are also only just beginning to realize? For example, researchers have theorized about one day sending a group of telescope probes into space that will use our sun's gravity as a magnifying lens, again allowing them to see far-off planets up close. This project, called the Solar Gravity Lens, is today backed by NASA. But might even a slightly older than us and more developed alien civilization have it already? We can't know for sure, but we can't rule it out. Beyond supercharged telescopes, one of the most popular ET conspiracy theories argues that really aliens don't need to watch us from afar by any means because they walk or fly among us. The idea is that alien beings can so seamlessly blend into human society, perhaps to the point that they bend physics to remain unseeable. On the simplest level, the ever-increasing number of UFO sightings in the 21st century has gotten the whole world talking. The footage isn't only grainy stills submitted by one-off members of the public anymore. There are now whole libraries of UFO clips, many of which come from within the world's militaries and governments. So perhaps that's how they're spying on us, by simply zooming around our planet going mostly unnoticed. Apart from occasionally when they slip up and do get filmed by us, using our limited video tech. But really, with or without advanced machines and capabilities, it would still carry considerable risk to spy on us from the inside. The safer bet would still be to watch from a distance, from a point that's determined to be just far enough away that we, the lowly humans, would never know they were there. Extreme space telescopes would then be one method, but perhaps the von Neumann approach wins out. True, we watch the skies today more than we ever have done in human history, but is it so unlikely that we could still be missing a nearby flotilla of alien probes, surveilling everything we do? Because that could be how aliens would most likely spy on us in real life. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.